warm welcome to Disky Talk with Luyolo. If you're tuning in for the very first time, I do ask that you please subscribe and hit that notification bell. If you've been a part of this journey, I hope you thoroughly enjoy this episode. So, I'd like to welcome each and every single one of you to the new year and wish you guys a happy new year. And I hope everybody has had a lovely festive period, and I wish blessings and success to each and every single one of you who's currently watching this right now. This is then a fantastic year for football, 2022. We do know that there's going to be the AFCON, there's going to be Club World Cup, and then the World Cup at the end of the year. Really can't wait for this footballing year then, because it is a great footballing year. However, on today's episode, we discuss all things Mamelodi Sundowns, Suprise Ralani and CAF Champions League, as we do know that the draw has been made and Mamelodi Sundowns do find themselves in a group alongside Al Ahly, Al Merrikh and Al Hilal. Let's kick it off then on today's first segment, which is all about Suprise Ralani. So, Suprise Ralani has signed for Mamelodi Sundowns on an 18-month contract. This obviously has brought mixed emotions with regards to his signing. Some people citing reasons of age. Some people then feeling like Mamelodi Sundowns is already a star-studded side. Why do they need him? You know. So when we have a look at Suprise Ralani as a footballer, this is a footballer from a qualitative perspective who ticks numerous boxes by virtue of the fact that he's so skillful, so intelligent, and he's also got an eye for goal. You know. And if you have a look at Suprise Ralani in his time at Cape Town City in the past three seasons, he's been one of the most consistent footballers within the league. You know, this is a player then who has been contributing with goals and assists consistently throughout the season. So a player then who is also a bit old school in the sense that he's a player then who plays freely. He's a player then who plays football at his own tempo, irrespective of the tempo of the game or the pace of the game. He's always able then to bring the game to his tempo. He's always then able to control the game and use his skill as well, you know. And just a great player to watch all around. One of my favorite players within DStv Premiership Football. So when we have a look then at Suprise Ralani signing for Mamelodi Sundowns. So the first thing that came to mind then with Suprise Ralani signing for Sundowns is that he's not needed by Mamelodi Sundowns, but he is a nice to have. And I could then make an argument as to why I think when it comes to CAF Champions League football, where he could add the quality and the value. However, when it comes to DStv Premiership Football, yeah, then he's not needed, because I mean, Mamelodi Sundowns have already opened such a huge point gap. And I mean, I think Mamelodi Sundowns need 4 or 5 wins and then they've wrapped up the league. You know, I just don't foresee Kaizer Chiefs or Orlando Pirates getting to that 53-54 point mark. You know, and once Sundowns get those 55 to about 58 points, that's about it. You know, and they've wrapped it up. You know, so from that perspective, they don't need a Suprise Ralani, because, you know, they walked the league and they've wrapped it up already, you know. But when we have a look then at CAF Champions League football, and we have a look at the quality that Suprise Ralani has. So I know a lot of people feel like Mamelodi Sundowns have so many players within this position. But let's just have a look then at how Mamelodi Sundowns have been doing business from a formational perspective. So we do know that they've adopted a 4-2-2-2. So this is how Mamelodi Sundowns would line up. And let's just have a look then at where would Suprise Ralani fit in, and how would he then be looking to make an impact for this Mamelodi Sundowns side. So this is the shape that Mamelodi Sundowns have adopted as of late. We do see them playing a 4-2-2-2. You know, at times it does become a 4-3-3 in opposition half. When it's really aggressive, it can go to a 3-6-1. So then this is a very dynamic team and a tactically versatile team by virtue of the fact that they enjoy so many different shapes and formations when they transition through different phases of the game. But when it's standard, it is a 4-2-2-2. So when we have a look at it then, Suprise Ralani then is normally a left winger by trade. But then how he looks then to play is that he would start off the left wing, which is vertical zone one. And he's always looking then to drift into that half space where he manipulates the ball very well. And he's such a skillful player, so creative, and also then has that final third penetration. He also then also has an eye for goal. He can also beat his man one-on-one out wide, deliver a cross. You know, this is a player then who is near complete when you look at it from a playmaker's perspective, quality player all around. So when you have a look then at this Mamelodi Sundowns side, I know that people will think of Serinho, people will think of Maema, people will think of Kapinga as well, because these are the other players who would normally occupy this position. So this is normally because they play with two number 10s. You'd have Zwane as the other number 10, and then you'd normally have either Maema or Serinho. This would be the other number 10. So this is where Suprise Ralani would fit in for this Mamelodi Sundown side within this 4-2-2 system. If they did play a 4-3-3, especially in CAF Champions League and how difficult it can get, maybe they want to pack the midfield, then I think you'd form part and parcel of a front three coming from the left, and then you have Zwane. But at the end of the day, these are very creative players, so they will tend to drift, you know, into different pockets and drift into different vertical zones and find themselves instituting that rotational play and that positional play that Mamelodi Sundowns do enjoy. But if it is then the standard 4-2-2 system, then this is what you'd see. So in this position then, you know, you've got Maema, you've got Kapinga, and you've got Serinho. So the issue then with Serinho is that for quite some time, you know, during this season, he just hasn't been on it. He is a player then that did want out, and I think his head has been turned, and his head is just not at Mamelodi Sundowns, you know. And I think it's very clear then when you have a look at his performances and the body language as well. This isn't a player then who shows that excitement, who shows that he still wants to play for the club, because we do know that when Serinho first arrived at the club, you could see it that he was happy, he was always smiling, and that's just one thing about South American players. You know when they're happy and you know when they're unhappy, and with Serinho, you know that he's unhappy. So I don't think that he's then in the best condition, especially then when we have a look at them going into Africa. I don't think he's in the best condition then to actually go out there and compete for this Mamelodi Sundown side, you know. And then you have a look at Kapinga, you have a look at Maema. These are two players who have shown glimpses of their quality and what they can do with the football at their feet. More so Maema with regards to the amount of assist and the amount of goals that he scored as well. And when you have a look at those two players, when you have a look at it then from a CAF Champions League perspective, the question then becomes, are they ready to step up? Personally, I don't think so, because I just feel that they haven't really established themselves yet within this Mamelodi Sundown side, and they haven't become those prominent household names within DStv Premiership football as of yet. And then you would have an Aubry Modiba who they would try here. Do I think that he's comfortable in this position? Look, he's a good player, he's creative, he's got football brains, but he's just obviously not on the same level as a Kapinga or a Maema or even a Ralani, in my opinion, you know. So when you have a look then at this position, it makes sense then from this perspective and from a CAF Champions League perspective as to why they go out and sign a Suprise Ralani, especially considering that Mamelodi Sundowns have been reaching the quarterfinals in the past couple of years. So they'd obviously like now to break into that top four barrier and find themselves making it to the finals and winning Champions League. And when it comes to CAF Champions League, you need all the quality that you need. So a lot of the times when Mamelodi Sundowns would go into Africa, from an offensive perspective, they'd find themselves heavily reliant on Themba Zwane and Shalulile. And the other offensive players, in my opinion, wouldn't always step up, you know. So when you add a Suprise Ralani, a player who's got the pedigree, who's got the experience, and who's also got the match-winning ability, then it does really add quality to this Mamelodi Sundown side, especially from a CAF Champions League perspective. Not for DSTV Premiership football, because we know that they've wrapped that up. But from a CAF Champions League perspective, then he would add that quality for this Mamelodi Sundown side. And I think, if anything, that's what the three wise men have eyed. They've eyed bringing him in to add quality for CAF Champions League football, and the experience that he has as well, having played in Europe as well, and how well he's been doing and how consistent he's been. Because if you have a look at his past three seasons, he's been one of the most consistent players. Whereas you have a look at Serinho, his head is not really there. You have a look at Kapinga and Maema, they haven't been as consistent as Ralani in the past three seasons within the DSTV Premiership. So this is where then I think Ralani would fit in for this Mamelodi Sundown side. You'd have Zwane there, you'd have Shalulile, and then you'd have Safranco. If not Safranco, you'd have Kutumela. If they do decide then to go with the midfield three, then you'd have a front three of Shalulile, Zwane, and Ralani. And when you have a look at it then, Ralani coming off the left-hand side, he would enjoy a great relationship with Lila K, because Lila K would offer the width, which then would allow Ralani to drift into that left-sided half space, where then he'd be able to play in between the lines and institute that creative action for this Mamelodi Sundown side. You know, so when you have a look at it then, I think that, look, Mamelodi Sundowns didn't need him, but he's a nice to have, and he does add quality to this Mamelodi Sundowns side, especially then when they look to go into the CAF Champions League and try win the CAF Champions League this season. And also considering the fact that there was a certain player that they were interested in, you know, in North Africa, and they just couldn't sign him, you know, because he would have obviously brought that quality. So then you have to go for the next best to add that quality to the side, you know. And when you have a look at it, then it is quite a star-studded lineup for Mamelodi Sundowns. And yeah, this Suprise Ralani signing, if anything, it does add that quality, because the player is a phenomenal footballer, you know, from a qualitative perspective. And hopefully then he hits the ground running. It's an 18-month contract, so it's a short contract. He has to hit the ground running, and he has to really perform for this Mamelodi Sundowns side. So when we move on then to the extra time segment of today's episode. So when you have a look at it then, it is all things CAF Champions League. So the draw has been made. Mamelodi Sundowns have been drawn alongside Al Ahly, Al Merrikh, and Al Hilal. So Mamelodi Sundowns then will travel to Sudan twice, because Al Merrikh and Al Hilal are two Sudanese clubs, and then they will travel to Cairo in Egypt to play against Al Ahly, where they meet former mentor in coach Peter Musimane and a former player of theirs, Percy Tau. So this is then quite a difficult group when you have a look at it then, you know, because CAF Champions League football is always difficult. Once you make it to the group stages, you know, it's not an easy ride for anyone. You know, it's just going to be very interesting then to see how Mamelodi Sundowns impose themselves. I did mention that within the DSTV Premiership, they have adopted the 4-2-2-2. Interesting to see then what tactical tweaks and changes do they make when they go into CAF Champions League. Against certain teams, they could go with the 4-2-2-2, but against a team where I would imagine if they're playing against Al Ahly, maybe they pack the midfield and go with three men in the midfield, you know. So also then very interesting to see how they go on to impose themselves. You know, this is a team that has been doing very well within DSTV Premiership football. They're playing some of the most beautiful football. And hopefully then they'll be able to translate that form into CAF Champions League. And it is then quite a tough group, but I do see Mamelodi Sundowns and Al Ahly advancing to the next round. And going then to be a mouth-watering encounter when Mamelodi Sundowns do battle against Al Ahly, both home and away, because I would like to think that these two teams are vying for that number one spot. However, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for tuning in to yet another special episode of Disky Talk with Luyolo. I hope, do let me know, what do you guys make of Suprise Ralani signing? Do you think that it's a good signing? Do you think that Mamelodi Sundowns don't need him? Or do you think that he adds the quality, especially with Mamelodi Sundowns trying then to go for that CAF Champions League second star? Or do you feel like it was a waste, they didn't need a Suprise Ralani, especially considering the fact that he would have been free within the next 6 months? And then when it comes to CAF Champions League, what do you guys make of the group? Where do you guys see Mamelodi Sundowns finishing? And what do you make of them coming up against Al Ahly? Thank you very much for tuning in to yet another special episode of Disky Talk with Luyolo. Signing out.